regulate your thoughts. So when it binds up your thought process from liberation, and then you mess around and meet the real Jesus, you're in a tug of war. This isn't the flesh and the spirit. This is a tug of war between religion and the real Jesus.
That's right. Yeah.
You got to go with freedom or bondage. Freedom or bondage. And some people can't handle the freedom, so they stay in the bondage. But the freedom is calling them. That causes a mental illness. And so they sit in the church, and we ignore them for years and decades. Decades upon decades. And they come in with ideologies about dress code and makeup and all of that. And we try to change their mindset. That's where the mental illness comes in. And so the misplaced sheep all around the world are just out there looking to encounter the real Jesus. To encounter a house where they can be safe in his arms for real. Not just the song. Safe in his arms for real. Looking at that yesterday in the beauty shop, all of the mental ill women, all the mental ill pastors and the mental ill first ladies, just mentally ill, it's in their face, it's in their conversation, and they need to be free. They need to be free. And so we ought to be thanking God for a place that we have a freedom. We ought to be thanking God that we have a place that we have a freedom in Him, that many people are after but don't want. Come on, y'all ain't saying nothing. They're after their freedom, but don't want it. Because they settle for the mediocrity. They settle for what we just talked about, that concert buzz. So we need to be lifting the Lord up. Lifting them up to the Lord. We need to be lifting them up to the Lord. Come on, let's just take a minute and lift them up to the Lord. Come on, let's just take a minute to let Him know that mindset, that mental illness state that's sitting in the church right now. mother who's been mentally ill for decades, just wanting to be free, but the dress code keeps her bound.
Oh God.
That deacon that's longing to be free, but finds his pleasure in looking at the young girls and touching them. Finds his pleasure in looking at the young boys and touching them because they never got really saved. Come on, we need to go down that street.
Come on.
Never got really saved, never got really converted. Mine's still messed up. Come on, we need to take a minute to pray for those pastors right now who don't know what kingdom work looks like. Come on, the pastors who don't know what kingdom work looks like.
Yeah.
And get those punks out of the pulpit. Get the microphone out of the punk's hand right now in the mighty name of Jesus. You can't be no punk in the kingdom. The kingdom doesn't produce punks. I saw some punk pastors yesterday. I said, the kingdom didn't produce you. You didn't come from the kingdom. You ain't been supping with the right people, man of God. You's a punk in the spirit. And if you're a punk in the spirit, you're a punk in the natural.
Yeah.
Because you're supposed to have power on this side.
Power.
But we just need to take a moment right now to just lift them up right now. And ask the Lord to get that punk out of them and make them strong in the Lord. He kept telling Joshua, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. So I don't want you to be no punk before the people, because they can punk you. And you can mess around and do just what Moses did and get mad and give it all up. But I don't want that for you, son, so I want you to be strong in me. We need to take a minute right now to lift up every praise and worship leader who thinks that this is a game. This is just a sport. This is just a way to get my career started. The devil is a liar. Let's take a minute to lift them up right now. Because if you don't know what an angel looks like and sounds like, you need to put the mic down. Come on, we just need to take a minute right now to lift up the wayward choir member. Who's in the choir talking about, is there anything more for me than this? Come on, we need to take a minute because the church is messed up.
Yeah.
And this is not the original design of the Lord.
Yeah.
This is not his original design. The church is, we don't have time. We need to take a minute right here. The original design of the church is messed up.
Yeah.
When I was making the bread this morning, he said my original design for mankind has been messed up. He said, because you are a weapon of mass destruction yourself.
Come on.
Because you like to self-destruct.
Come on.
But if you pick up my weapons of warfare, you're unstoppable.
Come on.
We're weapons of mass destruction.
Jesus.
We need to take a moment to get ourselves together. That's why we're fat. We're out of shape. We pick up trends. Because we're weapons of mass destruction. That's a mass destructive tactic from the enemy, and we don't even pay attention to it. I saw the coffin nails. And so what do you think that is? That's a Freddy Krueger kind of standard. They're making nails more and more sharp now. What do you think that is? Goddesses wear that, small g. But we want to be just like the world. Weapons of mass destruction is in your flesh. Your members can't tell the truth from a lie. Your members don't want to know the truth from a lie. And so you need to get, that's why Paul said, your members need to line up.
Come on. Yeah.
Who better to tell us than somebody who carried a machete on the horse?
Come on. Ready to go. Come on.
Paul was a barbarian in the natural, and then he became one in the spirit. Come on, God wants to use.
Come on.
Come on, God wants to use.
Yes.
Come on, God wants to use.
Come on, that's what he said.
He wants to use us.
That's what he's saying. Oh, shut down.
We're weapons of mass destruction. He said, that was not my original design for mankind.
Come on, come on.
That was not my original. I didn't make y'all like this.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
That's why I had to sing revival, because I don't like it.
Yeah.
Come on. Somebody said yesterday it was just dumb to me. timing, but this happened because of that solar eclipse. The enemy does not handle cosmic disturbances. That's not his job. Who gave him that jurisdiction?
Right.
It's happened because of the solar eclipse. No, that was set to happen for the years to come.
Right. Come on.
And it's getting ready to be the holy time, the holy seasons. God knows what he's doing. The enemy doesn't send flood waters.
Right.
The enemy doesn't make the moon go over the sun. He doesn't have that kind of power.
No, right. Come on.
Well,
that's real. That's real.
And so the mental illness people were like, yeah. And I was just like, no, no. This is God's revival.
Put your mind right.
And I got under the dryer.
Come on, because it wasn't real.
No, because I had said what I had to say. No. I'm not going to let you be mentally ill in my presence. You're going to stop that conspiracy theory crap in my presence. Because the Lord is not pleased with that. We have got, when are we going to get delivered for real? When are we going to get delivered from real? For real?
Yeah.
When are we going to stop letting the pastor be a punk before our eyes? Come on, I'm saying something right there.
Yeah, you are.
I said, I'm definitely not a punk, and I'm 100% woman. You're going to be a punk and let somebody come in and take over the church, and they're going to say, we in warfare. The devil is a liar.
Right, right.
The warfare ends with your mouth, man of God.
Right.
Come on, we got to take a minute. Just take a minute and lift up the church here. Take a minute and lift up the people here. Take a minute and lift up the body here.
Yes.
Because Jesus didn't take stripes for the stuff that we got going on.
He didn't.
He didn't walk God out. It's a shame that he had to walk God out the seal for this work that we got going on right here. Come on, we got to look at this in the face and stop being a punk about it, Tom. Well, we just gonna pray. No, we not. We gonna call it out.
Right.
Got to stop being. Come on, you got to stop talking about she got a lust demon. No, she's the hoe.
Ah! Right, come on. There's a big difference.
Jesus, the instruments are made for us to praise and worship you with. Hit the drums, God. Hit the congos, God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hit the bass. Hit the guitar, God. Hit the organ. Hit the piano. Hit all of it, God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Your house should be a house of prayer.
Yeah.
You said your house should be a house of prayer. People, come on, let's just take a minute.
Yes.
Come on, let's just take a minute and find the works of the enemy right here.
Yes.
Come on, let's take a minute and find the works of the enemy right here.
Yes.
We bind your works of filthy lucre. We bind your hand from the filthy lucre.
Yeah.
That's why the show the preachers was taking off the air. Glory to God.
Yeah.
That's why the show the preachers of LA was taking off the air. Glory to God. Preacher Lady Show was taken off the air. Glory to God.
Amen.
And we bind the works of any other.
Yeah,
we bind the contracts, and we even bind the conversations right now, God.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
we put a hindrance out right now. Send the bloodhounds out, God, to eat up the contracts. In the mighty name of Jesus. Send it to every network, oh God, and send the executive to shut it down. No, it's not a good idea. In the name of Jesus. Nobody's gonna watch it.
Come on, take them, God. But they're not ready.
I'm coming for the dove and I'm coming for the stellar.
Yeah.
I'm coming for the gospel appreciation. I'm coming for all of that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Only person that needs an accolade is the song that's called David.
Well,
the only one that needs an accolade.
That's right.
The only one that needs an award right there. Because he set up the whole worship service of the church.
Come on. The structure. Come
from
on.
Then until now, we're still following David.
Yes.
And so I'm sorry, man, but sir, you are not the best contemporary gospel artist this year. David is. Come on, we need to take a moment. Come on, I'm serious at the heart attack right here. We need to take a moment here.
Come on. I shot kind of.
He said, that's not my original design for mankind. Spoke that to me that he said, this was not my original design for mankind.
Yes.
That's why I got to shave my head at it. And I had to send blood waters to it.
Come on.
Because this was not my original design.
Come on.
Somebody said, well, you know, God needs to show mercy. He has.
We're still, yeah. Come on, we're still here.
Okay.
Come on.
More than half the nation is still alive.
Right.
He has shown mercy. God have mercy. No, God, thank you for your mercy. Earthquake that hit the bottom of the waters and sent a slight tsunami. God, thank you for your mercy.
Right.
Mexico is right under the United States, period.
Come on.
There's no jurisdiction greater than the other.
Come on.
Come on, we got this. Come on, we need to take a moment here. He said he wasn't pleased with our being.
Yeah.
And in this moment, we would want to be somewhere repenting.
Yeah.
We would want to be somewhere asking him to repent. And to save us.